My first memory of this board was when Mikey run me. I think you're in, were you in Ireland? You're in somewhere, sent me some footage. Sent me some footage of you surfing that little 3-footer, just going, fuck, this board's so sick.
Yeah.
And then he sent me some footage of him surfing that left. Like 10 foot?
Yeah.
10 foot?
Yep. 12
foot?
Pretty decent, yeah.
Big solid. Yeah. Same board?
Same board.
Same
5'11"? I was going to France and we were kind of just trying to make something. I'd just stepped away from competing. You were going to send some boards across and I wanted something I didn't have to like work as hard. Wanted something, a bit more foam and something I can just put as much power on a rail and it still hold. I guess that's how we, you know, you come up with the idea with real thinned out tail, pretty paper thin.
And it
just holds, I was surfing it in 2-3 foot little, you know, like little rights, and then surfing it in, like 8-10 foot less, and
solid.
It just still holds. Same, you know, even off the bottom and off the top, doing turns out there too, it was still holding just the same. It pretty much was like what I was thinking in my head. You just went, this is it. It doesn't matter if it's a point break or a beachy or a slab, it kind of holds all the same. Like with the more foam and the volume up front, it actually holds well when you're paddling into into a slabby kind of wave, because you need the board to get you into it. And then on the beachy stuff, you got that foam where you can kind of, you don't have to make the board work, you can just surf it, you know, and push as hard as you can.
Disguised, it's so much foam in here.
Because I went from riding 2 3/8 or 2 5/16 to 2.5. This is 2.5.
Yeah.
And it just, the rails are still the same, if not even thinner almost. And it just like, it's funny when you wax the board, you're waxing and you feel like you're actually going over this. You're waxing and it goes like this. Yeah. So there's so much roll.
You know, bit of outline up front. A lot of tube riding these days on your back ends, leaning forward over your front foot and over your, it just holds you up.
Yeah, that was when, surfing that wave in Ireland, taking off, you're always, no matter, on your back end, you're always leaning forward, pushing into, your board.
Yeah.
And it was kind of sick. It was, normally you'd ride, a real, something in bigger waves, you ride a narrow nose, but having that width, it was like it almost pushed against it and was giving us more speed. And especially obviously having the round tail and having it so narrow, you can still slow it down pretty easy by check turning or
watching off all that speed.
Yeah, it didn't matter how, I was going at a Mach 10 and just leaning out on that rail, on that tail, and it would just hold the whole way through. And you can see in the videos where it just it's a drawn out turn, but then right at the end I can still push that hard that it comes back up, almost getting there, holding the turn at first and then power driving through the rest of it. Oh, it gets me excited just talking about it. I want to go surfing.
Basics of the board, it's just a basic single double concave. The outline's been pushed forward, as we're just talking about. It's quite a compact. You're going to ride this board, you're riding a 5'11".
5'11", yeah.
5'11", when you might be riding a 6'2",
yeah.
6'4".
Yeah.
It really does wipe inches off what you would normally ride as what we used to think was a good waveboard, you know? I mean, it's just because it's got all the volume. If Mikey was riding 27.5 litres, I reckon your normal shorty was, then this board's pretty much going to be, 29, 28 and a half? At least 28 and a half. It's an extra litre, even a litre and a half. I'd almost say it's a monster rocker with a Raging Bull outline.
Yeah. All right. Oh, fuck, that's an all right system, eh?
We know what we're doing.
Yep.
So first cabs off the rank.
Sick. That's the first logo on a board too I've seen. That's sick.
You know, going back to that, the very original one that got Mikey frothing on this board was a 5'11".
Yeah.
And which, this is this is it. Yeah. It's still.
This is actually the exact same. Yeah, I'm this, looking at this there, is, right there.
This
5'11".
Is it.
Yeah, this 2.5".
Yeah, this is. This is exactly the board. It's like not a change. You don't change it.
Yeah.
You know, it's he stomped on it. He stamped approval. And it,
like on the high performance side of it, like I stepped away from competing and I was actually frothing to surf belts. I was like, I didn't get to surf an event with this board.
Yeah.
And it kind of made it exciting. I was like, I can't wait to go and do Bells a power
your,
hack.
Yeah, Bells was your first event.
Yeah, like,
on one of these.
And that's where I was just like, it actually made it kind of fun again because I was just surfing how I want to surf, not trying to surf to their kind of criteria. It was just big power turns and real drawn out, but then just, you know, throwing the power. One thing that I, you know, when traveling and stuff, changing board day in, day out when the swell changes and stuff.
Yeah.
When we were in Ireland, I just kept two boards in the car.
Yeah.
And just had, like, I didn't have to worry about bringing like a 6'4" or a 6'2", like those step ups. I was like, yeah, no, I'll just do it right this.
Yeah, one board.
Yeah. Made it a lot easier for sure.
One board around the world.
Yeah.
And that's, you know,
you get
shapers, we always like, you know, yeah, sure, we talk about all-rounders and they pretty much are for what we think is an all-rounder.
Yeah.
Beaches, locals, ups and downs and sizes. But this is seriously one board, you know. So if you're going to pack one board, grab a schooner.
Yeah.
Grab a schooner on the way to the airport.
You can get a schooner all around the world.
Yeah. There you go.